All right, so here we go. Doing a simple version of Jesus Culture Revival. I'm gonna start off by, I guess, going through the dynamics of the song because there are quite a few changes. It's a relatively simple song for the most part, but the dynamic changes make it really feel complex. And then the beats that they do have a lot of, I guess, tom involvement. And so that's what'll make it feel like it's a whole lot. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play it here. Hopefully it syncs up there later. I'm gonna record my drums through here. Come in. I'll go ahead and call out the different changes in the song. And let's go ahead and listen to it. So the drums do kind of start the song off. And so what I'm doing here is kick, tom, tom, tom. And we could simplify it even further, or just hit everything once. That's what they're doing. They're hitting multiple hits. And simplify it. Hit everything just one time. Same beat here. Out on the chorus. Make sure you do a swell on the cymbal. Just hit it. So when we come back in on the next verse, we're gonna have a constant on the kick drum and then also do the same thing we were doing with the tom before. You want to add the snare here. One, two. So this part, I'm gonna pause it because that drum beat is kind of complex, but we can simplify it. So it's So what we can do is, rather than have that complex kick drum pattern, we can just do something much simpler. So what is it's treat like a, it's called a simple backbeat. So we'll just do. It'll sound very different because having the kick the way they do it, it kind of gives the song a groove that they're going for. But as long as you stay consistent here, it should sound fine. Let's actually try that in the song just to make sure. At 154 there. So we're kick. So I actually change it up just a little bit halfway through to give it a little bit more variation. So you can do the constant But they can get really repetitive. So what you can do is one kick, snare, then two, then snare. And so that looks like this. So one, two, one. That's just a simple backbeat. So we're keeping constant on the hi-hat. That's all we're doing. And the backbeat on the snare. It's called the backbeat because it's at the very end of the measure, which is, you know, the four beats within the measure, and it's on the back end of it. So I'm using terminology, just forgetting about it. Okay, so that'll fit there. We'll play it again. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest of the song. This part on the bridge, leading into the bridge, the transition here. Pretty complex on the snare. They're doing like a kind of a marching beat. A marching snare. And so definitely not gonna want to do all that. So to, I guess, kind of fill it out, but not do so much, we can just have the kick there. Because what they actually do is for that part, they do a half kick and the snare, so it's and so, if you're not gonna do all this nonsense, then just hitting the kick will kind of fill in that gap. And really, if you wanted to, what you could do is that tom beat from the intro and verse one. Because we do wanna bring the music down here dynamically, but the way we change it, make sure it's enough of a shift to where you can tell, you know, we're bringing the music down and we're gonna bring it up throughout the bridge. So you really feel that dynamic shift. So an alternative would be that tom beat from earlier. So you remember from the verse, really simple. And that should fit fine there, actually. So we'll go ahead and rewind it a little bit here to about 245. No, further. Okay, so the bridge starts at 231. So we'll do. It does sound very different than what he's playing, but we won't have him playing in the background, so it'll be fine. Point is just to bring it dynamically low. So right there, they pick it up, and he's constantly on the kick drum, but it's the same up here, so is what he's playing. So what they're doing is so what he's actually playing is starting off here. Then when they start to build, they add that other kick. So it's just a So what you're going to want to do then, since we're doing the simple version, is on the first half, really simple. And then when you try to build, that's all you're doing is adding another kick. So the second half of the bridge is actually pretty, they changed the beat up quite significantly. So we'll just alter it a bit to fit there too. So at about 210 is where they do that shift. Yeah, So definitely don't want to do all that. So it's, so to simplify that, we will do, so we're already doing a full kick, right? Messed up on the third one. But anyway, so that's kind of what they're doing. It's a little bit different. They're hitting different jumps, but effectively that's it. So to simplify that, we'll do. Because the most important thing is to bring that snare in, but he's just doing that roll in front of it. So, but the most important thing is to bring that snare in. So, the simplified version again is, and then snare. So you can add more tom if you want. But the most important thing is to bring that snare in. They're hitting it a couple times, which I'm also not doing. Not necessary, for the most part. Let me rewind a little bit here. So I played a little bit wrong. So it's, and so, again, on that first one, the most important thing is just to have that snare. So don't worry about any doing any of that stuff. So for the first half, it's just going to be the simple version. I keep getting distracted because I'm trying to bridge the gap, I guess, between what they're actually doing versus what you probably want to do. Okay, so back to what you want to do here is, so for this, for the second part of the bridge, we're going to consider it to be in four parts, I guess. So first part is the, let me rewind it here and get you actual timestamps that you can use to kind of, because the bridge, since it's so short, it dynamically ramps pretty fast. So I'll go back from the beginning of the bridge and call out each of the parts. So the bridge starts here at 230. I'm gonna do a simple one here. So this is the first part. And then this is the second part here. Slight change. And third part. Add the snare. And if you can, you really want to drive on the kick here. Okay, so I missed that break, but it pretty much breaks there. So one thing is, don't try to get too caught up, I guess, if your hand isn't doing anything. For the most part, we just want to match the dynamics. So pick out, I guess, the most important pieces and then build on top of those. So as the bridge progresses, the kick is really what's driving it. So if you need to, I guess, not hit anything while you're on the kick, then that's fine. If you can't go that fast, that's also fine. We can continue to do that same beat from earlier and just add the cymbal just to make it feel a little bit different. Okay, so we'll go back just a little bit and then go into the cut So coming out of the bridge, they go back into the verse, and the drums are completely out at the beginning of the verse. So here we go. So actually, for the last bridge, just to bring it up a little bit more, I guess another alternative would be, so just to show that last bridge part. So we're doing the full kick, right? And ideally you want to be going this fast, but if you can't, then I'm gonna give you some alternatives for that. And so you'll be going this rate. Right. Really, just going that last part of the bridge, you just want to make it feel distinct. And so just playing a little bit harder, a little bit louder can do that too. But if you want to stay on that beat, that's fine to do. Not gonna delay this any further. Let's go on to, and so then out of the bridge into the chorus at 340 here. He sings through the first line, then we come in. And you just wanna hit the kick and then build. Alright, so how can we break that down, simplify it some here? So that build was pretty much the same as earlier, or using the same pieces as earlier, but a little bit differently. Rather than kick hitting them differently, so we're riding on a kick there, and then we're hitting both of these toms at the same time. So, and that builds up a lot of tension. And then it's constant, so it's the same as if you were hitting this. So, you know, the regular beat is this. So just remember at the same, like the same pace as you hit this is what we're hitting these. So, and then you just do that at the very end of the bridge, or not, sorry, the very end of the chorus when they come back in. That 3:38 is the cut verse out of the bridge. No, not cut verse, cut chorus. So out of the bridge is the cut chorus. And so then after he sings that first line, we come in. And then build here. So I'm gonna play that cut chorus again because I actually messed it up. I did the build a little bit differently, which is fine. You know, as long as you're hitting all of these, then really you can't go wrong. What I was doing was, and it might have confused you, I was hitting them all at the same time, and then halfway through I started doing that, which that was just my intuition, I guess, to do that. And so, but what I showed you was this, which I didn't do. So I'll go back and do that so you can see it. So 338 is where the cut chorus is. Drums are completely out. And come in low ish. So on the kick and toms. You can add a snare here if you want. And this is the drive. every time they say revival, you'll want to put at least a cymbal crash behind that, just to add some dynamics to it. So at this beat, the type of fills I do are pretty simple. You don't need to do anything crazy. Just a cymbal crash really will get you far enough in most cases. But some examples of ones that I do, or you could do in here. So it's three hits that you'll do in between, and then with a cymbal crash. And you can think of it as, I guess, three. No, I wouldn't say that. That's probably more confusing to say it that way. But that's all it is three hits and a cymbal crash. So if you practice that over and over again, you should get that one. You can throw that in. And then you can put this anywhere and it should sound fine. So it's left, right, left, or right, left, right, whichever one. Just only do three hits and then cymbal crash for this particular roll. And then it'll get you far enough. For a simple song like this. Feel free to change it up though, if you want. Sky's the limit for the simple song ideas as far as what you can put in between. But it's plenty. Just a simple crash is plenty. But I'm not going to make this video any longer. So hopefully this is good enough for this song. I'm going to go edit this together and send it over. I never hit record on my video over here. So I guess this will hopefully be enough. I could play through the whole thing again, I guess. Just do a full run through. I'll do that. Probably best to do a full run through anyway. So we're gonna swell in on cymbals and then simple toms. I was messing with stuff, so okay. And then out on the chorus, first chorus, and then when we come back in on verse two, same tom pattern, but we're gonna double up the kick. If you wanna add cymbals here to kinda bring it up dynamically, you can. Here we go. Only you, only you may darkness shake. And only you can make dry bones away. Back into the pre-chorus here. You gotta add the snare. Doing the same beat as the intro. We wanna see hearts ablaze. We wanna see people change. We wanna see revival. Now full kick here. Add the snare. Same thing, but with the cymbal. Then out, this is the cut chorus. So now we're gonna build back in a little bit. We're gonna go double kick from the beginning. No snare yet though. Now we're gonna build. Then the chorus. Back to the chorus. Anywhere we go from here will probably be pretty dynamic. So go ahead and call it there. That's a full-ish run through. That's the whole song. That's all the parts of the song. So should be good from there. Hopefully this helps.